Now, the NDIS bill, it's been delayed, sent back to a parliamentary committee. Is this about more scrutiny? What's going on here? You're saying it's going to cost hundreds of millions of dollars, this delay.
Yeah, I have with me a letter which I'll leave with you. It's from the actuary of the NDIS. It says that the delay of 2 months to this reform bill will see an extra $1 billion put onto the national credit card, which it shouldn't. And when I say $1 billion, maybe people think that's just monopoly money. It is the equivalent of funding 60,000 kids on the scheme for a year. It's the equivalent of everyone with a diagnosis of MND getting support for a year plus more. Now, the Liberals are saying, oh, we're rushing it. For 2 years, they've said we're not doing enough to fix up the NDIS. We had a one-year review, thousands of people consulted. This Senate committee, which the Liberals want to put the draft bill to look at, has already had 12 weeks. All that we're going to get in the next 8 weeks is 2 days of public hearings. That's going to take, according to the actuary, $1 billion. And I also just do a little bit of homework for my Kieran Gilbert interrogation. The sort of things which we want to stop money on the scheme being spent on include fines and penalties. We want to make sure that people are not buying jewellery and watches. We want to make sure that people aren't taking cruises or trips to Japan. We want to make sure that we have legal costs not paid for by the NDIS. We want to make sure that, trampolines.
Yeah.
And these are ordinary matters. The Liberals...
One of the things that Liberals have, Coalition and other critics have raised is sex workers that...
They're obsessed about sex workers.
Can you get that ban in?
Yes.
Well, what's the late? Can you get them across the line before the winter break?
Well, we should be able to. You know, all the Liberals seem to think the NDIS is spent on is sex workers, which is a complete lie. I don't think there's been a claim approved in ages on it. What we have is operational guidelines, what you can spend money on and what you can't. But the problem is because the legislation isn't well enough drafted, when the operational guidelines are tested in the courts, we lose. So what we want to do is use Section 10 of the draft bill to say, this is in and this isn't.
Yeah.
That provides certainty for participants, means we use evidence-based therapies. Like, the Liberals are now fighting to the death to spend an extra $1 billion so people can get cuddles therapy. Like, I have to say to the Liberals, wake up. There's a cost-of-living crisis.
Yeah.
We're trying to do our best with tax cuts and energy prices. Aussies are paying the taxes. And the Liberal Party is playing a shameless game where they think $1 billion, this is classic Liberals, when it's government money, they don't actually think it's their money, but it's actually taxpayer money and participant outcome.
Will you try again before the end of the week?
Oh, listen, I have brought a packet of Tim Tams and I say to the Liberals, you like a biscuit? Let's have a biscuit and a cup of tea and save $1 billion for participants, then you go on a two-day frolic. If there's two public hearings in July, that's $500 million each day. And the Liberals say they need time to look at amendments. They've had 12 weeks. Listen, I don't think they're the brightest tools in the shed, some of them in the Senate, but, you know, the sharpest tools in the shed. But we can work out amendments. We've done national security amendments on far less time and not even a Tim Tam.
OK, Michael Sukar, if you're watching, the Tim Tam offer has been made.
Tim Tam time, Michael.
Bill Shorten, thanks for your time. Appreciate it.